Hello, and welcome to Skitty Animates. I'm Skitty, and today I'm going to talk about our first viewer-requested topic. Preethi Anand asks, could you please explain or show it in Maya how spacing and overlap lead and follow with a short animation? I'm going to leave lead and follow for the next video since it's a slightly different topic, but let's jump into Maya and talk about spacing and overlap. First, we will start with a simple ball bounce example, and then once we have a basic understanding, we'll move on to a character pose shift. The short and sweet explanation of spacing and overlap is a visual representation of how fast or slow the object or character is moving. There's a very useful tool in Maya called Ghost, which can be found under the Visualize tab on the animation shelf that will show us what I'm talking about. What we're looking at here is the ball's position on every one of the 65 frames making up this animation. Essentially, the ball overlaps itself during the slower parts of the arc, but when it loses momentum and drops faster, the ball is spaced further apart. The more frames you use, and the closer together the images in those frames are, the slower that action will be. Simple, right? Well, an explanation, yes. An execution, that's another story. Part of it is understanding the basic physics of how things work with gravity. The other part is using your artistic sixth sense to feel for what's right. To understand the physics involved in a standard ball bounce, let's analyze the translate y on the graph editor. Translate y represents the up and down of an action, so the graph for the translate y will show us the height of the ball over a period of time. So here, at the beginning of the ball bounce, the ball starts at its highest peak, but is in the process of losing all of its momentum. This is when there is a slow shift in control and gravity takes the reins, plummeting the ball to the surface. Immediately after hitting the surface, the ball has built up enough force to take control back with no transition period. The ball has full control as it shoots back up, not making it quite as far as it did before. Gravity kicks in again, and we end up back at the slow transfer of control. This process repeats itself until there is no force left in the ball and gravity wins. How long this takes will depend on the weight of the ball and where your artistic sense tells you. The heavier the object, the faster gravity will win. The weight in my example is probably somewhere in the range of a tennis ball. Now that the painful part is out of the way, let's move on to the fun little pose shift I put together for this example. Instead of turning on ghosting for this one, I'm going to pop over to Photoshop to not ruin the surprise because the animation is a little special. I've screenshotted every frame, so let's flip through them now and see how it overlaps. As you can see, there's a bunch of overlap in the beginning, a large gap with a gross-looking stretched pose in the middle, followed by a whole bunch of overlap at the end. This probably doesn't look like it would work because of how ugly this one pose in the middle is, but let's play it in Maya and see what happens. This technique is called a smear. I'll make a video in the future on this topic, but for now, just notice how the pose shift itself is only 4 of the 30 frames. The remaining 26 are all in the antic and the settle. These two points are the most important information that the audience needs, so it's where we need to put our emphasis. If we scrub this slowly, you'll see he first antics away from where he's going, but he also antics into his antic. He's using his force to pull into his winding up position, which means he dips down to push himself up. After spending our time here, we quickly snap him into his destination without worrying too much about his feet staying planted since it's so quick. He pushes himself up and then settles with the help of gravity. It uses the same principles as the ball bounce example, just with a more exaggerated approach. And that's all I'm going to say on spacing and overlap. If you have any questions or a topic you'd like me to discuss, leave a comment below. Like and subscribe if you found this video helpful at all, and a link is in the description if you'd like to follow me on Twitter. And until next time, thanks for watching.